people of Reddit. What happened during your childhood that was so hilarious? Even thinking about it today can make you suddenly burst into laughter. My friends and I were hanging out in the hallway of our high school. The floors were made of concrete or something that had been worn smooth over the years. A friend of mine with a smirk dropped the banana peel from his breakfast on the ground. My other friend Steve said, "That doesn't really work in real life, you know," to which he responded, "So go ahead." My friend Steve proceeded to line himself up and then do an extremely cocky arm-swinging walk, and when he stepped on the banana peel his body flew forward and he was exactly parallel to the ground when he dropped on the floor hard. It was one of the funniest things I've seen in my entire life, and we learned the on the right surfaces and banana peel will ruin you crap. I was screaming the house down because I was suddenly completely blind. Then my grandma flung open the door and I could see her in her nightgown illuminated in the doorway. Turns out I just was used to city lights. So when I woke up in the middle of the night at her house in rural Wisconsin, my eyes didn't adjust quickly enough and my 7-year-old reptilian brain let loose. My cousin who was sleeping beside me still reminds me of this incident. And I was the opposite at my nan's house. Really dark at home, but Nan had a street light right outside the window and lit up the whole thing. She didn't know because it was the spare room and never slept there obviously, but it was so bright. Then someone drove into the pole and knocked it down and it was better. I kept a very messy room as a kid. My dad came to tuck me in but didn't turn the light on. As he went to leave, he stepped in an empty plastic container which then slid across the carpet, throwing him off balance. Obviously tensing up to get his balance, he let out this massive fart. I still cry laughing when I think about it. When I was in an airport bathroom at about the age of 4, I asked my mom if it was possible to poop out my bones. It had been such a big concern of mine, enough to bring me to tears. I had this same fear. It stemmed from being constipated. I was convinced it'd crap out my pelvis. When my older sister and I were very young, about 4 and 8 maybe, we and some neighborhood children were talking about which kind of Native American we had in us. My sister sent me to ask my mom. Well, she was in the middle of a conversation with her friends and either I thought she was talking to me or she was just being in butt. But either way, the answer I got from her was lesbians. I ran outside and up the sidewalk and yelled, "Sister's name, we're lesbians." My family still laughs about it. I'm in lesbians with you. It didn't make me laugh at the time, but as an adult looking back, it cracks me and my entire family up. My grandfather was a wonderful man. He was kind and generous and funny. His brother, my great uncle Gene, was an abusive crook who treated everyone like dirt. They died within a year of each other. At both funerals, 7-year-old me took the opportunity to sit next to my favorite uncle, Uncle Mel, who I rarely saw due to distance. My grandpa's funeral was very sad. Everyone was teary, but glancing around Uncle Gene's, I noticed no one was crying. Not even his wife, Uncle Mel. I whispered, "Why isn't anyone crying?" "Trying to be a good Christian," he told me, "because we're all glad Uncle Gene is in heaven. But you cried at Grandpa's funeral. Comma, well, we miss Grandpa." Someone gave me a real boomerang when I was 11, which was my favorite thing. We lived in a semi-rural area, so there was plenty of room to throw it around without it getting damaged or it damaging anything. Anyway, if you're really skillful with these things, apparently you can get them to come back to you. I was not a good throw, so I was constantly throwing, running and picking it up, throwing again. One day the planets aligned, I pulled my arm back and flung it as hard as I could. It was a big throw, a beautiful throw. I watched it go up and circle, spinning, spinning, spinning. It circled perfectly and started heading straight back to me. I was mesmerized. It clocked me right in the nose and knocked me off my feet. I had to walk home covered in blood. Mum thought it was hilarious. I don't remember ever throwing it again after that. When I was little, we went to McDonald's. My mom told me I could have a normal sized meal because I didn't want to be a little kid and get a Happy Meal all over again. So I look up and see that they have the big and tasty burger, but I somehow didn't read it at that. When I went to order, I exclaimed loudly, "I want the big and nasty one, mommy. Gimme the big and nasty one." The clerk was holding back tears and so was my mother. She then corrected me and I got my big and nasty burger in the end. I remember being at a McDonald's with my mom and aunt. They used to have this sign that said "over 80 million served." I misread it out loud as "over 80 million survived." We weren't supposed to watch TV when we got home from school, but both my parents worked, so it was a rule that impossible to enforce. So whenever you heard the garage door open, signaling my mother arriving home, you had to turn off the TV and look busy. She was obviously never fooled, because she's not an idiot. At some point this turned into a game where my teenage brothers would hide from her, and it made my mom laugh really hard. They would shove themselves into cabinets, under beds or under desks, etc. My one brother once hid by laying flat on the couch in front of the half wall between the kitchen and family room. She must have heard him because creeped up and peeked over out of his sightline. For some reason she was feeling punchy, so she lay down on top of the half wall and just rolled herself off the wall on top of my brother, who had no idea she was there. It was the most ridiculous thing I had ever seen her do. Same rule, but we had a really old TV that had to warm up for 10-15 minutes after it was turned on. Until then the picture was really garbled. So if my parents got home and turned on the TV and it worked, we were freaked. Man, I hated that TV. When I was in 8th grade, my best friend Nate and I each had our first real girlfriends and were really into this making out thing that we had just discovered. Nate's mom was an English teacher at the school and had her own classroom. She was out for the day at a conference, so Nate had the idea to sneak out of lunch and bring our girlfriends up to his mom's empty classroom for some tonsil hockey time. Things go as planned. We bring the girls up to his mom's classroom and get to making out in opposite corners of the empty classroom. What we had somehow failed to remember was teachers have substitutes when they're not at school. The door opens and this guy walks in, turns on the lights and is as surprised as we are and yells, "What are you doing?" Neither Nate nor myself were used to getting in trouble, and Nate was very caught off guard and responded, "It's okay. I'm my mom's son." He was trying to get across that he was allowed to be there because it was his mom's classroom, but all that came out, repeatedly, was, "It's okay. I'm my mom's son." I was playing basketball alone one day. Ball went right next to a guy riding a bike, and so he tried to grab it for me with one hand. Well, when he went to lean over, he turned the handlebar with his other hand, went over the front of his handlebars and landed face first on the cement. Dude was trying to do something nice for me, so I had to hold back my laughter. He was fine but super embarrassed. After he left, I couldn't stop laughing. My uncle couldn't find the chocolate syrup in our refrigerator. It was stuck to the back of the milk. So every time he took the milk out to look behind it, the syrup would go right along with it. He started getting so frustrated, and we all could see what was happening every time he did it. Now anytime something goes missing in the house, we ask, "Did you check the back of the milk?" There was also the time when grandma lost her marbles. She was just sitting there one day and said, "You know what I can't seem to find? Those old marbles I used to have." We all kind of paused and then burst out laughing. When I was 6, my grandpa took me into a large department store to shop for some new clothes. I was utterly bored and uninterested, and did the kid thing and hid in some clothing racks. Well, one thing led to another, and I ended up knocking over a rack. Would have been bad enough by itself, but the store had all of their clothes racks lined up just right to create what my immediate family calls the Great Domino Racks. Every rack in the men's section knocks into another, and another, and another, until the whole section is in ruins. My grandpa was so mad. I'm surprised I'm alive today. Looking back, I feel like it must have looked like a cartoon. A bunch of racks knocking down, and in the center of it, a scrawny little white girl with gigantic curly hair staring at her grandpa as wide-eyed as a deer. Makes us all laugh, still. As someone who works in retail, and has seen kids do this, everyone who worked at that store is probably still seething. I was helping put siding on a house, helping as in handing tools and tacks. Up on the ladder was my mom's boyfriend. Great dude. Funny, but he had this tiny mahogany hammer I'll never forget. He forgot he left it on top of the ladder, went to move it, and guess what came falling? That little hammer. The sound it made when the wooden handle hit the top of his head and made the funniest doink sound. I still laugh about it. Oh man, I can hear it, and it's hilarious. My father, who is a very mellow and mature man now, had anger issues into his 30s. He was known to sometimes throw small temper tantrums. When I was 5, we lived in an old mobile home with horrible flooring. After he got off work, my mother asked him to take out the trash. He threw a temper tantrum, stomped and fell through the kitchen floor. My mom laughed her butt off. He became even madder and she said, "That's what you get for acting like a big baby." Later that night and even now, he recalls the story and laughed about it. He admits that he was a big baby back then, but after that, he worked on his issues and never threw tantrums like that again. It's still hilarious though. My mom laughing at him was just icing on the cake. How did he work through them? I have those issues as well. I remember when I discovered that when I wore satin PJs I could slide on satin bedsheets. This was so cool and fun to 10-year-old me, and I had to call my mum to come and watch me. She comes into the room and I run as fast as I can onto the bed and slide across it and then continue sliding off the bed and landing in the open wardrobe upside down. I was laughing and crying at the same time and I still get teased for it. When I was about 17 and my brother was 7, I drove him to his theater practice in an old Chevy pickup that I inherited from my great-grandfather. Prior to this trip, I had convinced my brother that a car seat rat, named Pepe, lived under the bench seat. I told him this story to discourage him from dropping toys and food on the floor of the truck. Well, as it would happen, my brother dropped some toy he was playing with on this trip, and began he to complain. I told him to reach down anyway and get the toy, to which he promptly refused and claimed that Pepe would bite his fingers if he tried. I told him that Pepe would eat his toy unless he grabbed the toy before it was too late. My brother then slowly reached down under the truck's bench seat and began screaming louder than I had ever heard him scream before. I began to panic and said, "What? What's wrong?" And that's when I caught a white blur in my periphery rushing toward my face, which immediately draped over the side of my head. I grabbed the object, and to my absolute horror it was a used pair of my great-grandfather's boxers. I immediately began screaming and threw them back at my brother, who continued to scream. I demanded that my little brother put them back where he found them, and I never looked under that seat again. I later traded in that truck when I bought my next vehicle, with my great-grandfather's used underpants still hiding under the seat. It's someone else's problem now. I thought it was going to be a real rat. It's Christmas Eve mass and none of us want to be there, but it's the 90s and it was that time when mom and dad had to convince themselves and us it was important to go to church. We're in the bad seats because the C&Es have showed up and squished us all out, and one of the nuns has the microphone so she could speak to the children. She asked, "What is a birthday? Do you know what a birthday is?" And my 8-year-old brother grumbles to himself, "It's another year closer to death." My mom, dad, and I have to work very hard to keep the noise down as we pee ourselves laughing. Pretty sure that's when my brother realized he was the funny one in the family. I asked my father once if he could cut the watermelon for me. He was happy to do it. He placed the watermelon on a plate with such confidence. He took a cooking knife and did this ultra-confident swing to cut the watermelon. Instantly, the watermelon was cut in half, but so was the plate. We just burst into tears. We laughed so loudly and for a long time. He was so confident about it but just completely forgot to use a wooden cutting board. Whoa. I need a knife like that. I had a big old afro when I was a teenager. One day, my buddy and I were out for a bike ride in some posh neighborhood, and some girl across the street also on a bike is just staring slack-jawed at my hair. She rode right into a telephone pole. I used to get home from the bus stop about 15-20 minutes before my dad. We had snow piled up almost to the top of our wooden fence. Minnesota, typical, so I decided I wanted to play on it. I ended up slipping and one of the fence posts got caught under my coat and left me dangling. I tried so hard to stand up but couldn't catch any grip. When my dad came home, there was his daughter just hanging out, tired and defeated, patiently waiting for his help. I bet this visual alone makes him lose it just thinking about it. Grandma made pancakes for my little cousin, probably around 6 at the time. Cousin says, "What kind of piece crap pancakes are these?" "Crap jacks." It's 2004, I am 10 years old, my brother is 6. We are home alone. I am watching some boring thing on Nat Geo. I decide to go to the corner store to buy bacon and eggs to make breakfast. I have a 15-minute discussion with my little bro, telling him how he will not go outside when I am gone under no circumstance, not to answer door, etc. But most importantly to not go outside while I am gone. Start making my way to corner store walking. About 6 minutes walk halfway, notice my brother jogging towards me. I am like, WTF did I tell you? He says, can I change the channel? It's boring. Thinking of that simple moment always minimally puts smile on my face. I have a family member who was told to stay home by her father and to not answer the door before he left. The doorbell rings a minute later. Family member opens door. It's her father and he yells at her, I told you not to answer the door. 10 years old trick or treating in town on Halloween night with two friends. My one friend, happy as ever, is swinging his candy bag as he crosses the street. It suddenly bursts from the bottom, scattering his precious candy all over the road. His demeanor immediately changes from joyfulness to extreme terror. My other friend unleashes his max volume, contagious joker-like laugh, causing me to laugh so hard I collapse to the ground. Simultaneously, a car turns onto the road as if to threaten the possibility of salvaging the candy. Candy explosion friend starts screaming, help me, as he's desperately trying to scoop the candy to safety with the full length of his arms. I'm laughing so hard I literally had to crawl to the sidewalk. Your friend laughing maniacally made this for me. LOL. I was making macaroni and cheese once and I hear my mom running and yelling something to my dad who was outside. I turned around just in time to see her bounce off the screen door. She ran right into it and flew backwards. She had all these smudges on her face and she looked so bewildered. 20 years later and it still cracks me up. My uncle had a blood phobia with his own blood. One Thanksgiving morning, he cuts himself making a bagel, faints, and the paramedics have to come out. About 4 hours later he takes off the band-aid while washing his hands and reopens the wound. And down he went again. Same paramedic team comes to check him out, and give my family the filthiest looks because at this point we are all watching. My dad is filming. My mom and aunt are in near tears of laughter. Anyway, that is how he got out in charge of only deep frying the turkey. I lied. This isn't the funniest thing that happened. When I was 11 we went to a nature preserve and my dad tried to feed a giraffe out of our sunroof. The giraffe was stood in front of the car, so he couldn't escape when it started to drool on him. This was big, vicious, slow-moving drool. He was squealing and carrying on, making dolphin noises, trying to squirm out of the way, desperately trying to save his tie and suit jacket, while the drool just slowly descended onto him while my mom and I just lost our crap. I cannot tell this story in person, I will still nearly start crying 20 years on and no one believes it anyway. My cousin had really bad adhesions as a kid, and we went on a family vacation to Disney World. We were in line for the Flying Dumbo ride, and he ran through the line before it stopped and Dumbo's ear hit him right in the eye. After Disney World, we went on a cruise in the big red boat, took a family picture together. There's a family photo with us, and I'm scowling because I had to wear socks with my dress shoes, and my cousin has a huge black eye. It was great. This sounds like one of those photos where the adults are initially super pee that we can't even have one nice, happy family photo, but in the end, it's really a way better memory and more fun to hang up. Dad used to sit on a tiny plastic chair to brush my sister's and my teeth. One night, while aimlessly brushing my sister's teeth, he lets one rip so loudly and harshly that it cracks the plastic chair in half, making him sprawl backwards. My sister and I still occasionally bring it up to embarrass him if he's making fun of us. Love you dad, but your farts are deadly. It was when I was a teenager, actually. I worked at a stable, and I went to dismount my mare. Only I was being tricky and instead of swinging my leg over her back end, I swung it over her neck and then was going to jump down. But somehow the saddle horn went in the pocket of my down vest. I was basically dangling from the saddle horn while my horse was wandering around the barn looking for snacks. You shouldn't have been horsing around. I got my butt stuck in a dining room chair. I was a small child and slipped my legs through the back rung trying to be funny. I ended up getting stuck and not being able to get out. My dad ended up having to saw the bottom rung off. I was worried he was going to saw my butt off. He put it back and you were never able to tell which chair it happened to, but left me with a story that they won't let me live down. I got my toe stuck in an exercise bike once. I tried to get off and my foot was stuck and I fell off and started screaming. Thankfully after 10 minutes my aunt was able to dislodge my toe and it was just black and blue for a while. My sister figured out she was a lesbian around the age of 12. After that self-realization, she became very openly lesbian. Like the gayest gay you ever did see, which is brave for Georgia, but just wait. That year at Thanksgiving, my grandparents from Derby, yes Derby, Kansas, were in town. Following the annual tradition, my family went around the Thanksgiving table saying things we were thankful for, our health, food, stuff like that. And then comes my sister's turn, and in front of both my grandparents she proudly proclaims, "I am thankful for big boobs. I almost choked on my cider. I find the most erotic part of a woman is the boobies." When I was 12, my mom took me and two friends out to the small local year-round park type thing for my birthday. They had rides and a huge IMAX theater. We had gone to lunch at a local pizza place and were walking back to the amusement park, and I was holding a small pizza box with my pizza leftovers. While walking, I was trying to talk my friend into going on a specific ride with me. I was explaining that the only feeling you get is the centrifugal force and a small jerk to the side. I mimicked this motion and the pizza box flew out of my hands and hit some innocent business looking man. The look of pure horror on his face after getting pelted with pizza by a random 12-year-old makes me laugh every single time. My brother is autistic and had a lot of routines that were very important to him. One was that after school every day, he would take his watch in one hand and his favorite box fan in the other and go out to my mom's car and sit in the car in the garage with those two items for like 20 minutes. She was usually home at that hour, so he had regular access to the vehicle. But at some point, I got older and she was comfortable leaving him home with me babysitting. The first day she left him with me after school, he went out to the garage to do his routine and the car wasn't there. He had no idea what to do and just stood there, staring at the empty bay. After like 2 minutes of silence, he said, "What am I going to do now?" I left him to figure it out on his own, and when I returned 5 minutes later, he was sitting on a folding chair on the garage floor where the car used to be with his fan and his watch. Good enough, I guess. Another time, I was sitting there doing my homework, minding my own business, and he just walked up and put his mouth onto the side of my head. I'm like, "WTF?" And he replied very calmly, "I'm eating your hair." Like it was a completely normal thing to say. Lmao. My 8-year-old son has autism and I could see him doing both these things. It's all about routine and sensory seeking with him. P. I am and was quite fat. On a family trip, we went to a historic town in my country and we saw some nice totems. One of them was in the middle of the street and my mom wanted to take a picture with me and said totem. The totem was a short, chubby gray one and I was wearing a gray t-shirt. When my mom revealed the picture, this was before digital cameras, it looked like my lost twin. My brother lost his breath when he saw it. Pick or it didn't happen. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.